Hello everybody, this is Greg with Mineral Springs Tilapia again. I got a lot of comments last week about how clean the tanks were and how nice everything looked. Well, I took that video on the day that we cleaned the hatchery. So I don't want you to get the wrong idea. This is not, it's not always that clean. In other words, okay, here we go. We're going to start up the same area. This is a breeder colony. This is the largest breeder colony and the dirtiest breeder tank. That big female there's got a mouthful. Another breeder colony. There's four fish there. There's another one missing. I don't know if she's hiding somewhere with a mouthful. Oh, here she comes out of the tube. Let me knock on the glass and see if I can get her to come out. Nope, she doesn't have any eggs. But these are, I don't think I've got any holding in this tank right now. Another tank. This little girl here's got eggs. And she's the only one with eggs out of these guys. Another breeder tank. Now in this tank I have two. I've got that one's holding and that one's holding. Come around here to the other side. These are blues also. There is one of these fish. She's right back there in that tube. I just tapped on the glass and she popped her head out. She's got a mouthful of eggs. These are Niles, and I think there's two in here. This one here inside the tube's got a mouthful. And I think that one in back of the tubes has got a mouthful, but I don't know if I can get her to come out or not. So I've got a couple holding in here. So about six fish holding right now. Fry tanks. Again, nothing is as clean as it used to be, but again, nothing is as full as it used to be as it was last week. This tank that had 600 in it now has 150 to 200 in there. This tank I didn't mess with too much last week. You can see it's a little dirtier. There's still about 400 fish in this tank. And they're doing good. There's a lot of food grade in there, a lot of 1-inch fish. Up here, fry, still a bunch of fry, doing okay with fry. Here's some, these are anywhere from a half to an inch. Not a lot of 1-inch fish in here, but a lot of 3/4-inch fish in this tank. Another tank again, not as clean as they are on the day that we clean them. There's about 300 in here. Maybe 300 in here, 250. Down below, let's see what I got down here. I've just got one tank of fry down here. The other one, two, three tanks are empty right now. These two tanks here, these two 20s, they're still pretty clean. They are the fish that I'm growing out for breeder fish. There's going to come a point here soon where I'm going to have to replace one colony. And we're in August, we always get busy selling breeder colonies, so I'll have these fish to choose from when I'm pulling breeder fish. On the other side, this tank's got a couple of little fish in it. It's a dirty tank. I've cleaned it out, sold all the fish out of it yesterday. These are Nile fry in this tank. Still pretty clean. The fry don't really make the tanks that dirty. About 125 in this tank. These are blues. Now there's 600 or 700 in this tank. There is a lot of, you can see them down there on the algae discs. There's a lot of fish in this tank. And good number in this tank. Don't have any in that tank. These are fish that are coming up for sale. These fish are food grade. They're an inch long or better. These are aquaponics grade, which are 3/4 of an inch. These are pond grade, which are slow growing fish. This is another tank of fry. As you look through those pictures, you'll notice that none of these tanks are as clean as they were last Sunday, which was the 10th, which is the day I did my last video. And I purposely try to do videos on Sundays or the day of cleaning or day after cleaning so that you can see what's going on. It's difficult to see in this stained water, a lot more difficult than it is any other time. But I just wanted you to know it's not, my tanks are not crystal clear like this fry tank here. They're not that crystal clear all the time. I let my tanks get stained to a point, and then I have a day of cleaning, which is every Sunday. My grandson comes in, helps me clean tanks, and we clean 33 tanks on that day, filters and everything included. So just wanted you to know this facility is a clean facility, but it is not, it's a long ways from being perfect. You know, I've got messes in here all the time. The day after shipping is really tough. I've cleaned it up since I've shipped last. This whole area over here, which is my shipping area, I put the boxes on here, fill them out of all these buckets here. I've pulled and counted the fish into the buckets. These pumps are running whenever I have fish in these buckets, of course. You know, I've got a lot of work to do yet, but I'm getting the system figured out in here. This whole thing's relatively new to me, but it's working out well. I shipped about 1,700 fish, 1,800 fish this last week. That was my biggest week ever. I'm averaging 600 to 700 a week, and I did almost three times that, so pretty happy with it. But anyway, subscribe to my channel. I'll try to give you as much information as I can. If you have a subject that you want me to talk about, just shoot me a message on the YouTube channel and I'll take care of that for you. And I'll answer any questions I can in the next video that you may ask me, or I'll just respond to you if it's a question that not everybody may deal with. I'll respond to you over the where you leave the comment on my channel. But anyway, that's what I've got going here right now today. I've got a lot of work to do out here today and tomorrow, and then shipping again starts on Monday. So we will see you next video. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel and let me know if you want to see anything in particular. Thank you. See you later.